So I'm going to show making of pizza base using the auto cook menu in my microwave oven. Got the ingredients laid out here. So I've taken 200 grams of maida, 1 tablespoon of yeast. So this is a simple method in which everything is mixed together. You don't have to keep the yeast and warm water sugar mix separately. So this is how you do it in this method. So take 1 tablespoon of yeast, 1 teaspoon of sugar. So everything is mixed in the flour itself, and 1/2 a teaspoon of salt. So I mix all these well, and there is no need of any lukewarm water or warm water. So I just use plain water here to make a soft dough. So this has become soft dough now. So I have to just cover it and keep for 1/2 an hour. So I've been using this multi-cook tawa, so I'm just keeping it covered, and I've set a timer here for 1/2 an hour. You can see that it is grown. So now I have to roll it out as a like a chapati or roti. This will be a thick one. The size of this. Just prick it here and there with a fork. So I'll leave it like this for 5 minutes, and then I'll keep it for baking. In the meantime, I'll select the category utility corner. In that, FE1, 200 grams, press start. So now it's gone to the convection mode, preheat. After this, I'll place this low rack, and on the top of that, I'll keep the multi-cook tawa. So during preheat, you're not supposed to keep anything. So now it is beeping, that means I have to open. It's going to take 7 minutes. So in 7 minutes, the pizza base will be ready. I just press start. Now that it is beeped, it is you can remove it once the fan switches off. This is actually a thick base. It is ready. You can see the base is completely ready, totally ready to be used. But it's a thick variety. I will show one more method in which I'll make a thin crust pizza base. So this is just the base. I'll show how to make the pizza after this. Quite hot now. So once it cools down, it's ready to make the pizza. The tawa is this size, 9-inch size. It's a 9-inch multi-cook tawa. It's just 9 inches, so that is what I made. So this one I've done using the auto-cook menu, just following the instructions given in the manual. So now it's totally cold. So I'm going to put it in this IKEA Ziploc cover stud. So this is how they pack it and sell it in bakeries. So I'm going to bake the pizza with the sauce and the toppings tomorrow. I'm not going to refrigerate, I'll just keep it outside. So earlier I've shown making one thick base. So now I'm going to do 2 bases out of this. cheese also up to you. You can use as much as you want.